टू क्रॉप क्लिप और इमेज. एज यू कैन सी आई हैव प्लेस्ड वन वीडियो क्लिप एंड वन इमेज ऑन माई टाइम लाइन. दिस इज वीडियो क्लिप एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज माई इमेज. सो हाउ वी कैन क्रॉप दिस टू. आई वॉन्ट टू शो ओनली दिस मच पार्ट ऑफ दिस वीडियो एंड फॉर इमेज दिस मच. सो हाउ वी कैन क्रॉप. सो फॉर दैट वी हैव टू फर्स्ट प्लेस द कर्सर ऑन वीडियो एंड देन गो टू क्रॉप ऑप्शन. इट विल ओपन वन न्यू क्रॉप एंड जूम विंडो. हियर यू कैन सी देयर इज अ ग्रिड. कंप्लीट स्क्रीन इज सेलेक्टेड एट दिस मोमेंट बट वी वॉन्टेड टू शो ओनली दिस मच पार्ट. लेट्स सी, वी हैव सेलेक्टेड दिस मच पार्ट. नाउ प्ले. एज यू कैन सी वी हैव सेलेक्टेड एंड नाउ इट इज शोइंग ओनली द सेलेक्टेड पार्ट, नॉट द कंप्लीट पिक्चर और फुल वीडियो स्क्रीन. There is a one ratio. When we selected, the aspect ratio was remain same because we have selected 16:9. If we select 4:3, the window size will be like this. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 is custom. If we want to custom means we can select of any size. Not the fixed dimension 16:4:3:1:1 or 16:9 or 9:16. Okay, I will continue with 16:9 and this is my projected or display area. Select OK. Now if I play here, it is not showing the complete picture. Okay, the same thing we can do with image. Now we want to crop this image, so we have selected, crop it. Now it is showing. Now we can select this portion what we want to show. Play. Now we can see the difference here. This is the complete picture and this is the crop one. Okay. Now we will play. How to use pan and zoom. I have already placed one clip on my timeline. As you can see, let's play. So you can see this is the complete area of this video. I want to zoom on this particular face. So how we can achieve? It will start from this and it will zoom to his face. So just put a cursor on this and go to option crop. This option we have already seen in the crop video or images. Now we can see there is a one more option, pan and zoom. Click here. The moment you click, you see there is a start and end. At this moment the start is selected and it is showing this is in green color. The moment we click here, it shows where you want to end and this is area. So we can move this area to this and we can resize. And okay, let's play. Now you can see it started and zoomed on his face. Okay, there is a ratio as well what we have seen already in the in the crop video, there are different options you can select. Select OK. Now we'll play. Okay. We will see three more options. Here, I am copying this. Now there are four clips, same clips. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have seen the first one, second one, third one, and fourth one. The same effects are coming. So now I am moving to second clip. Now this is selected. Go to again crop. You can see the shop option selected. Now here you can see there are four more options. This is from far to near. This is near to far. So at this moment, this is selected one. The moment I click this, it will reverse the direction. Okay, so I am moving this to his face and then play. Now it is reverse motion. Okay, the same thing I will moving this playhead and selecting this image, place this crop, select this crop. And now we'll select the third option from left to right, and we'll move start from his face and then here, then play. Okay, so and I can reset because I was not able to see his face properly, so make it a bit large. And then play. Okay. Now I will select the fourth clip and will use fourth option, right to left. So and is here. So let me make it bigger. I will also move this here. Oh, let me select here. Play. Or if I can move here a little bit, see. Okay. Now we have applied all four types, we will see the output. First one, second one, third one, fourth one. See, it is zooming from on his face on the first clip. In the second clip, it is moving away. Third clip, moving right. The third clip, moving left, right. So we can apply all four options using pan and zoom. As you can see, I have placed two clips on my timelines, so there is a no transition involved, right? So for that, to add transition, we have to go to the transition. There are 233 transitions are available. So let's see, if I select this, you can see the preview when you double click here, or you can see the blur. So whatever you like, you can select from here let me go here, film stock, double click here, you can see the preview. So let me add this here. This is the first transition I have added, and then slideshow. Let me add this here. Let's play. Or let me go here, and then we can see. So this is the transition of video or clip number one. And this is a transition of clip number two. So this is the use of transition of video, or this way we can do the transition of videos. I have selected one, this titles included first default title. Let's see, double click. There is a no effects presently, it is just coming and remain on the screen. Let me put it on my timelines. See it again. There is a no effect. Okay. To fade text in and out, just right click on it, go to show properties and go to advanced. Go to animation, select fade to, double click on it. Now we can see okay, now we can also adjust by dragging this in and out time. Let's say this clip is for 5 seconds, so I want this should be started around 1.5 seconds. As you can see, this is slowly fading in and here fading out. So let me put it around this 4 seconds. Now slowly we can see the impact. This is fed in or this is fed out. Okay, we just need to select this fed to and adjust the time, and we can play here and can see the impact. Okay, let's start. I have already placed one clip on my timelines, so we can see this is a full view of this clip. Now I want to apply mask on this clip. For that you have to go to effects and type here selected included mask. We can see two options, image mask and shape mask. There are two ways we can put it on the timeline or clip. If I place it on the track 2, then we'll see mask will be applicable only for the duration for which this is starting point, this is end point. Only for this duration this mask will be applicable, right? Or second way is that we can select and drag this on the clip, then it will be applicable this from starting to end. Right, we can see one more thing, just put this shape mask to starting and drag it to the full time of this clip and then select properties. Here we can see the position of this mask, right, X and Y, and we can also set width and height of this mask, and this is a feathering effect as you can see on the preview. We can give presently this area is height and we can see this area. If we want to revert, we have to select this invert mask, then we can see the rest of the part but not the center one. Apply. So this is the use of mask. I have already added one clip or video to my timelines. I want to add shake effect when I am passing through this bridge. Presently there is a no shake effect. Okay. To add shake effect, we have to go to effects, include, select shake. So there are almost 8 type of shake effects are there. So I have placed here and we'll see. But I don't want to keep it so long. I want to keep it just the moment when I am passed over this bridge up to this time. Let's see. And if you want to make it or keep it a bit long, then we can stretch this. Let's see. Restart. This way we can make a video or give shake effect to any video or clip. How to make a video or add freeze frame? This is clip I have added to my timeline. Okay, and I want to freeze it here. Then what I will do, I have placed my cursor or this playhead at this point, and then right click, add freeze frame. So by default this duration, let's see, first we will see it has freeze this and continue, right? So but we don't want to freeze this frame for so long. And what we will have to do, the duration, right click, check the speed and duration. So presently it is showing 5 seconds, so make it 1. Okay, then we can see it has reduced. We will play it again. So this way we can add freeze frame in the clip or video. How to fade to black? I have positioned 3 clips on my timeline. We will see first how this clip is working. See, there is a no transition to these clips. They are, this is ending this way as it is, and it is coming. Just to fade to black, what we need to do, first go to transition, type here in this box fade. You can see this fade. So let's see, I'm at the end of the first clip, how it fades. Just select and drag at the and place it at the end of this clip. Now we will see the transition effect. Now we can see there is a transition effect. This clip is fading to black. See it once again. Okay, and we can also do one thing. We can select and drag in both these clips. Now see the impact. This is fading out and this is fading in. Once again, fade out and this is fade in. And we can select this and we can increase the duration as well. Let's see. This is slowly fade out and this is slowly fade in to black. We can place this. This is fed in to to this clip, and this is fed out and fed in. And we can do this with each and every clip. Now let's see. This is fed in. And it will be fed out to black, and the second clip will start fed in slowly. As we said, we have set the transition of this is fed out to black and this is fed in. This way we can fed to black, in and out to particular clip. I have already placed one clip on my timeline. You can see this is color, and we want to make this black and white. For this, we have to add effects. So go to effects, select included, type in this box black. This is black and white one, and place it here. Now see impact. This clip or video has become black and white. We can stretch up to the end of this clip, and we can see it has become black and white. How to transit a clip or video from black and white to color? Presently, this clip is in color. Okay. So first, what I will do, I will cut it or split in two parts and will add effect black and white to this clip, this or this part. Okay, so now this clip has a black and white effect, right? Let me make it to this. So we can see this is black and white, and it will transit to color. But we want a smooth transition, so we have to add transition. Go to transition, we have a fade, put this here, and let's see. So slowly it is transiting from black and white to color. We can also increase the duration, then it will move or transit slowly. As you can see, I have already placed one clip on my timelines, Dancing Girl, and I have another clip, Flying Flower Leaves, and I want to overlay on this clip one. We have seen this preview. We can select and drag on the timeline, and we can position as per our requirement when we want to enter this. Okay, if we want to move from the starting, we can move and then play. Let's see on preview. This way we can use the overlay effect. You can see this is very neat and clean picture, right? And we want to give old film damage, old film effect. For that we need to go to effect, included. Here we have option old film and damage film. So we can select any of them. If we select leader here, place on it and play. we can see the effects, overlay effects. And if we want to see the effect of what is the difference, just double click on it. It will show you the preview here. So we can select as per our choice, and else we can go to old films, and there are almost 25 effects, overlay effects are there. Retro films, we can see here. Just drag and drop on this and see the effect on this, right? As we can see, old films, there is a too much brightness, right? We can go to the color correction, adjust, just undo or reset everything, remove this color enhancement, and we can also go to color, reduce the brightness, and then OK, and then play. Now we can see it is giving a effect of the old film, a damaged old film. How to add cinematic black bars. As you can see, I have already placed one clip on my timelines. There is a no top and bottom, and we want to add cinematic bars to this clip at the top and bottom. How we can achieve this? Just go to effects, select included, type here cinematic, select this and place it here. As you can see, it has added this black bars at the top and bottom. If we remove this, now we can see this is full, right? We can stretch this timeline. Let's play. Now we can see the black bars at the top and bottom of this clip. This way we can add cinematic black bars to any clip or video. How to make video with flicker effect. As you can see, I have already placed one video and audio on my timelines, and let's play. You can see this flicker effect. So I will explain you how I have achieved flicker effect. So you can see I have placed one image, flower image. Let me open this one and used one black screen. Let me delete all this. So first go to sample colors. Here we have a black screen, so we have to place this on the second track, and we have to set the position from where we want to start the flicker effect. So I want to start the movement when they are flying this. And second, I have used this flower image, so I will put on this black screen. Okay, let me crop to fit this, so we can see the full image. Now, to split any image or video, we use right arrow so that it will move one by one, one frame, right? And to split, we have a shortcut, Control B. So I will use right arrow and then Control B, right arrow, Control B. So this way we can split this image. Right. Let me continue this. And now I will select the black screen. And will do the same thing here. Move, cut, split, and we'll do the same number of split as I have done with image. Okay, now I can remove this both. Now what I have to do, I will remove this every alternate one. Same thing here. If you are not able to see, you can increase this way. Spread this and now, let's play. Now you can see we have achieved the flicker effect. We will see how to make a video or clip reverse. It means how this clip will work in a reverse way. Okay, presently I have placed one clip on my timeline, and after, at the end of this clip, I want to show a reverse motion of this clip. What I will do, I will place this clip again at the end of this clip, and now I want to make this clip work in a reverse. Select speed and duration. Here we have a reverse speed. Select this. Okay. And then see. Now we will see from starting. This way we can make any clip or video to work in a reverse way. I have placed one clip, and this is the normal speed of this clip. Okay, what I will do, I have selected this, click on here, and I am resizing this here. Okay, and I will copy this and place it on. I will copy this and place it on the second track. Now what I will do, I will take the same clip and place it on the second track. Now you can see this is zoom. I will select this and again resize this. And we'll place one more clip here, same clip, and we'll resize here. First one, this is the first one, this is the second clip, the third clip we have here. So this is normal speed, this is normal, this is normal. I have placed these three clips on the screen, same clip with normal speed. Now I want to make this one slower. Click. Then we have to right click and go to the option speed and duration. The present duration is 8 seconds. So I want to make it slow. So here is speed, duration. Either we can select the speed or duration. And we always select ripple edit. To make it slow with the time, I have selected 16. So this time has increased. This is normal time. And now I want to change the speed, or want to make it fast forward. Instead of 8, I will make it to 4. Now we will see What happened? This is the first one. This is second one and third one. Second one is a normal. This is a slow one and this is fast one. Now we can see the difference. The fast one has gone. This normal has gone. And this is the third one, slower one. So this way we can make any video slow motion or fast forward. How to add end rolling credits? What is the use? The use is we use this end rolling credits at the end of any movie or any program to show and who were there in the casting crews, like who was actor, actress, producer, director, those kind of details. Okay, so to add that, we have to click here, titles, click on included, type here credit. So first one you see, this is a credit one and rolling credit. Drag this on this timeline. Okay, we can see here, just play. Well, let me play this on full screen. So we can see cast credit 1, credit 2, credit 3, credit 5, name 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right? This is the end credit which display at the end of any movie program. Okay. So this way it moves or display. So how to edit these names? Right click here, show properties, go to advanced. Okay, so here we can see there are details, cast. So we can click here, credit one, we can mention here director, name one, VCG, knowledge, channel. Right, and play. So you can see director, VCG, knowledge, channel. So this way we can add rolling credits. Okay, and in this example I have not added any image or any clip. So this is a background is black. Okay, if you wanted to add any clip or background, so we can add from here. Let me select so you can see here. At this moment we cannot see any rolling credits because we have to, this image is on the top, so we have to move it to down. Now you can see, play, right, click on OK. Okay, and we can also, we can also set the position by selecting this. Okay,